Hello. In today's session of visual communication ideas, I would like to show you how you can see the structure inside the text and how to extract it and create some more visual form. So we're going to do work with this kind of example. So we have a text document as a source, and I'm going to change it to some more engaging diagram which express the same type of information. And as always, before I start doing redesign of the presentation or of the document, we should spend time firstly on analyzing the content, just then to move to the slide design. So this is our source information, source document. There is a text explaining, comparing like how to implement the artificial intelligence process as the whole system. And this text is saying that actually from outside or for this process can seem very simple. There are just three steps. However, in reality, there are much more steps inside. So that's covered in the second part over here. And at the end, we have summary saying also that this kind of information is, there's another level of concerns which you should take into account. So actually looking at the text, we can already see some content which can indicate us what kind of information, what kind of visualization to use. So for example, when you see the words first, then last part inside the bullet point or just the plain text, this actually should already indicate you that there is a kind of process, there is a kind of procedure, three steps. The similar if you have here the bullet points, maybe the list of items is there. Sometimes it's hidden, sometimes it's visible like this. Again, like here, if we have more hidden list of points, so from like the constraints from, for example, data sources, blah, 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 to something else. So that's the list of items which is hidden in text. Looking further, we can see that, for example, the first paragraph is saying, but okay, the first view of implementing this AI process, the second paragraph is actually comparing and saying, no, this is not that simple. There is the whole process is much more complex. So you have comparison of two views hidden over here. Similarly, I mentioned like the bullet points can represent the list. Again, bullet points with some information about the time or order, that's actually the process. So we can maybe show it with some flowchart diagram. Again, we have a list here and they have last information over here saying that, okay, everything is impacted with some constraints, which is actually kind of structure information. We can say, okay, over the comparison, this main comparison which we have here, there is kind of extra layer of structures of concerns we should be also adding there. So let's take it step by step. But before we think about what kind of visualization to do, I'd like to remind you there are several basic diagram types. And I'm going to use diagrams as they are like just simple graphical form of representing information. And so if you have a list of items, the list diagram is just a set of boxes which we can use. Structure diagram are good to use when you want to express also the location of the items. So if something is above something or inside, some hierarchies, dependencies are covered here. And when you have information about the order, so then the flowchart diagrams are to be considered. So let's take the first part of our text where we have these three items of this simplistic view of the AI implementation process. We can change it actually to numbering because these three items actually are in order. They are not like just random order. Firstly, you need to take data, then apply method, then get the results. So it's quite visible from the text. So that's why we should actually use the flowchart diagram. And the simplest form of flowchart diagram is this one. Just put a rectangle with the text and some fine form of arrow. You can spend some extra minutes to beautify it. Add some illustrations over there. The simplest form of illustrations are just adding icons. So for example, just choose the icon for data, this databases icon or AI. Man with some gears in the head as a symbolic representation of the artificial intelligence. And the value, this is quite abstract form. It's not that easy to find something, but the value like something shiny, some stars as a representation of something as added value. If you want to search for more ideas how to choose the how to find the icon for abstract terms. I'll put the link below the video. I have put together a blog with about 60 icons of abstract ones and some ideas how to we can choose icons for them. But let's get back to the our second part of the text, which explains the how the whole process looks in the real world. So again, we have these three parts over here. They are first, then, and last part, so it will be flowcharts. However, we'll have some more details inside. So we see that, for example, we have the first part, which is information gathering. Then second part is applying data science, which has several steps inside. So the data engineering part and data modeling, and the last part. If you want to put more details inside, okay, we can actually extract from here, but there are more steps, but they belong to the subgroups. For example, data engineering has these three bullet points, modeling has these three steps to be put in. So you can still, within the diagram, can put more details inside. Just remember to put them, the local dims, properly, so they have this kind of structure information inside the flowchart as well, and ensure the readability, so the contrast is kept, so the main information is more visible. You can see the the background is more contrast than just the content, which is the, in my case, the bullet points. And then so putting it all together, we can express this comparison. So we have the simplistic view over here, data, AI, and value, and the same three levels, just in more details, as a real world implementation is like this. So we just put it over here. There was the last part of the text, which was addressing the whole parts, so this, that all parts are limited by some constraints. So this is again the structure type of information, and structure, I mean, like expressing this structural information again by some, could be just by simple shapes, like, so for this one, if I put the rectangle over here, it will express that this rectangle is actually addressing all three parts. So this is my structure information. So by this one, I don't have to write that all parts are limited. I just can show it by one rectangle, which is under all three parts. So that will be the final diagram. So we had this kind of information in the beginning. And after working with the text a bit, understanding the content, finding the words which indicate the structure, we change it to this kind of diagram, which is easier to understand. Also, it's easier to present because it's visual. Our brain processes it much more faster than the written information, which is more abstract. So consider using this kind of techniques for your text, for your content. These three types of diagrams, steps, what to search for. I hope you can find it inspirative. To learn more and get more tips and resources, I encourage you to visit our website, infodiagram.com, where you can get a free sample, you can sign up, and you will get a series of email tutorials on other aspects, how to visualize content, how to make it more engaging.